Hello, anatomy colleagues. This is Dr. Alsop, and in this video, we are going to discuss the three main types of muscular tissue. So there will be three. As this is the musculoskeletal portion of the course, we will focus most of our conversations throughout on skeletal muscle. But I do want to introduce the other two, mainly so we can differentiate. Now realize that you will go into considerable more detail regarding cardiac muscle tissue when you're discussing the heart, and smooth muscle when discussing many different areas, but particularly the gastrointestinal system. But let's introduce the three types here. We'll start with skeletal muscle cells. Now this is named skeletal muscle because these muscles mostly attach to bone and will move the skeleton when they contract. You will most likely hear that skeletal muscle tissue is striated and voluntary, which is true-ish. Striated refers to these alternating dark and light protein bands. So you can see this obviously is a cartoonish illustration, but if you were looking through a microscope, you would see fairly distinct alternating dark and light bands. So that's where the striations come from. And these muscles, these skeletal muscles, are mostly voluntary, as in these muscles are consciously controlled, with a few exceptions. Next, there is cardiac muscle, which cardiac muscle is going to be unique to the heart, forming most of the muscular walls of the heart. This muscle is also described as striated, which you can see here, but these are going to be considered involuntary. So the actions are involuntary, as in not under conscious control. So you do not constantly think, beat, heart, beat, or contract, 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 contract. That would take over your life. So these are going to be involuntary. The heart is actually super neat in that it has its own pacemaker that will initiate the contractions of the muscles of the heart. So cardiac muscle is autorhythmic. But note that certain neurotransmitters and hormones can adjust the heart rate. Lastly, smooth muscle is characterized as being non-striated or smooth. That's where it gets its name, so you don't see any of these lines here, as you see with the other two. And smooth muscle will also be involuntary. You will have smooth muscle all over the place, but in particular, the viscera or organs of the abdominopelvic cavity will be composed of smooth muscle. And also, you'll have smooth muscle within the airways and blood vessels. Okay, so this question is actually a bit of a review from the last video in addition to this one. So you have to kind of recall concepts over more than one area, which is kind of the point. Think about, you may have concepts from two different videos on one assessment question. So, question. All muscle tissue has some degree of elasticity and extensibility. But which type of muscle tissue is capable of the greatest levels of these properties? Is it cardiac tissue, skeletal muscle tissue, or smooth muscle tissue? So as this question notes, all muscle tissue will have some degree of elasticity and extensibility. So recall, those are two of the four properties of muscle tissue. But only one of these three will really have the greatest capabilities, or to the greatest extent of these two. Which one is it? What do you say? Pause if you need to, but if you're ready, let's talk about how C, smooth muscle, is the correct answer. Think about a bladder or the stomach. These organs are composed of smooth muscle, and they can extend considerably and return back to its original shape to a much greater extent than, say, the biceps brachii, which is a skeletal muscle, or any of the heart muscle as well. All right, excellent work here. Congratulations. Please make sure to review these concepts, and always feel free to reach out with any questions. Thank you for your time and attention.